Good morning, all of you. Today we are going to discuss about a small topic in AWT, so that is menus. So before going to explain how to create menu, I will show you the output, then you can understand how this particular program is going to be work out. So then you can better understand the concept. So for example, so what is happened here is, if I execute this program, the menu has been created. So whenever you are seeing any applications, we have file menu, edit, like that option. See here, if I click on menu here, I getting the item 1, item 2, like that. If I click on file, we get new, open, save as, like that. I have created one menu item called menu, and then that I have item 1, item 2, and also it's contain a sub menu also. Like this, if you want to create a menu, how it can be created, I can explain simply. So first of all, we need a container. Here I am using a container called as the frame, and after that, to place these all menu items, we required a component called as the menu bar. So how we are going to create a menu bar is, menu bar MB is equal to new menu bar. So it is like on the container frame, it is like a base where we can place our all menus. So for getting the, so when you see the output, on that I have the menu is displayed. So for that menu, how I am creating is, menu is equal to new menu of menu. So like that, on menu bar, if we have different portions like file, we have view, toolbars, like that, so we have one menu. So again, sub menu. So if you see this output, in this output I have a sub menu is also there. How I created this sub menu is, again, that is also one of the menu. So menu sub menu is equal to new menu of sub menu. So like this, I have created two menus. Now each see this output here, I have, if I click on menu, I'm getting item 1, item 2, item 3. How these things are created is, they are menu items. So here I have created menu item 1 is I1 is equal to new menu, like that. I have created 5 menu items. So in this output, only 3 are directly visible. If I click on menu, item 1, item 3 are showing. Again, after I am getting sub menu. How this is done is, see here. So I have two menus. One is normal menu and another one is the sub menu. I have added I1, I2, I3 to the menu by using the method menu dot add of I1. So add method I am using, but I am, which component I am adding is for the menu only. So that's why. And after that, I have added I4, I5 menu items to the sub menu. Now again, I am adding this particular sub menu not to my menu bar. I am adding to the menu. That is why within this particular menu only I am getting the another menu. So this is how we have added. So I am added my sub menu to the menu. Again, this menu has to be appeared in the menu bar. That's how I made it is mb dot add of menu. Now see this. Now to make my menu bar visible, how I made is f dot, what is f? F is the frame class object. F dot set to menu bar of mb. So that particular menu bar has been placed on the frame. So like this. So first of all, we have created what? So I again repeat, first of all, we have created menus and menu items. So slow by one, first of all, we added menu items to the menu and added the menu to the menu bar. And after that, menu bar is added to the frame with the help of the method set menu bar. And the frame size has been set by using set size method. We are here not following any layout. And we made my frame visible with the help of two. When I close this particular program, it is closing. How it is closing is, here I am using the window listener interface, and within that I am using the adapter classes. Here I am using anonymous class concept. When I click the window close button, automatically window will be closed. In that, for closing, I am calling the method system.exit. So this is how we can create a menus very simply in Java. So next concept is similar to the menu, but different kind of menu. I will show the output, then you can better understand how this. So here I am not having any menu. I don't have any menu. But if I click here, automatically the menu is up. So like this, for example, on your mouse, if you click right click, sometimes if you click right click, then automatically menu up. That kind of a thing, how we can make it is, that kind of menu we're going to call it as a pop-up menu. So here I am created the object for the frame class. We need a container, same, and we have made so this is not normal menu with on the click it is coming. That's why it is called as the pop-up menu. That's why I'm created an object called as pop-up menu for the class pop-up menu itself. And here I made my frame and pop-up menu as final. Why? Because I doesn't want to reassign, that is only one object node to be exist for that particular thing. So I doesn't want to recreate it, only one component to be existed, one instance only. So for that I made it as a final. And now after that I have created my menu item, same in the previous concept, menu item. And when I clicked on the cut or when I clicked on the anything, so for that I'm adding the commands, how it is, cut dot set action command. So what is the purpose of this particular set action command is, on that particular menu item, whatever the information we want display, that information we can display with a command called as the set action command. If you don't use set action command, the title, whatever the cut here is, that is taken as the default. So like that, I have created three menu items, menu item cut, menu item copy, menu item paste. So all of these menu items I am added to the pop-up menu by using pop-up menu dot add cut, add copy, add paste, like that we're done. Now here when I clicking on, once you if you see the output, if I click on the menu, I click on the frame, wherever I click the pop-up menu is appearing. How it is happening is, here for my frame I have added the mouse listener, and also I am using the anonymous classes concept. Here I am using the adapter classes. If I click there, automatically the mouse clicked method will be called. In that I am using this method pop-up menu dot show. So show the frame, so that particular F frame, wherever I clicked, so that coordinates positions is given by the getX method and getY. That way exactly it is showing that particular F object in that particular position. So on pop-up menu on the frame. So F is indicating the parent. Who is the parent for that particular pop-up menu? So now I am added my pop-up menu to the frame by using F dot add of pop-up menu. And the frame size we can set by using set size of, and F dot set layout we not set anything. And after that we made our frame visible by using set visible. To close the frame, we are using the window closing of window adapter class. So this is how we have created a pop-up menu. So next concept is, so whenever we are working with our AWT programs, we want to generate some kind of alert. See here, if I click on the button, automatically another window is appearing and it doesn't allow, not allowing to the access. For example, if I want to click on the parent frame, it is not allowing to end. Why? Because alert message has been like this. If you want to prevent some action, how far that we can generate this kind of dialog boxes. So if you want to generate the warnings, alerts, some anything, so we can generate those things by using the concept called as the dialog. So until this dialog closes, we cannot do any operation with the parent window. So how we can create this kind of a dialog is very simple. Here, see this, when I clicking on that particular button, so you know how to when you click on a button, how we can call any method is by using the action performed. So you remember that within that action performed, what I am doing is, so I am creating a dialog. D1 is equal to new dialog of frame comma. So for that particular dialog, then I am giving the name by using this particular second parameter. And what is meant by true is, in this particular dialog constructor, so the frame is indicating the parent. Who is the parent is frame. And the name of the particular dialog, and what is the true is, if you doesn't want the parent to be interacted with the user, in the previous output, if I trying to use the previous frame, it is not permitting me. Until you close the dialog, that particular parent cannot be allowed to access. So for that, we have to, when we're creating a dialog, we have to make it as a true. So this is how we can create a simple dialogue. So everything you know. So one new method here I want to discuss, that is a pack off. What is the pack off thing is, if you want, normally we can set our frame size, but if it doesn't want to set your frame size, you can use the pack off. So pack off the method, what it will do is, it is a default for the layout manager. It will automatically, depending upon the user settings, user graphical settings, it will going to set the frame sizes and its bounds, everything can be done. So that is the advantage of pack off. So if you doesn't want your frame to be adjusted according to the system you are using, the machine you are using, if you want to make it that, so how we can make it, how we can do that is, we can call a method called as pack off. Automatically it will allows the layout manager to set the default layout according to the system settings. That is the advantage of method called as the pack off. So next topic is font matrix. So what is meant by font matrix is, so first of all I will show one diagram, then you can understand what is the use of font matrix. In Java programming, in AWT programming, we can create a font, and whatever the information we can display on the top of the frame or applet, we can display by using this particular text. But here, if you want, whatever the text is displaying, if you want to know the height of the text, so different details of the font, how we can retrieve these, for that we have to use a class called as the font matrix. For example, here the character I is displaying on one particular line. This particular line is called as the baseline. This particular line is called as the baseline. On top of the baseline, what is the size of the particular character can grow, that particular, see here, the first sphere is up here. So this maximum size is, so whatever the span up from the baseline, the character can be progress, that is called as the ascent. And see here, the G, from the baseline, the G is progressing towards the bottom. So that particular height is called as the descent. And what is leading is, for the next line, the character appears after this particular leading space. So that particular just height is called as the leading. So whenever anyone asks you what is the line height is nothing but ascent plus descent plus leading. So I again repeat, what is ascent is, this is the baseline. Wherever the character is positioned, that particular position is called as the baseline. From the baseline, how much the character grows, it is called as the ascent. And what is descent is, from the baseline downwards, the character growth is called as the descent. And after descent, between the next line and current line, the space, the logical space is called as the leading. That's why whenever, how we can calculate the line height is equal to ascent plus descent plus leading. And so this, see the another parameters. So caps, whenever you're having capital letters, so this height is called from baseline to the another line called as the mean line, something will be there. So that distance is called as the cap size. So what is typo size is, so from this particular, wherever the characters will be, so what is typo size is, descent plus ascent is called as the typo size. So this is how we can use different font metrics which are available. How we can use them programmatically, I can show with the help of small program. Please see this. So see here, I have an applet program. In this particular applet program, what I am doing is, here I have created one string called as the hello, hello Java, and for that particular, after that font, I want to maintain a particular font. So how I made a particular font is, font F is equal to new font of Arial comma, so the style I want to use is Arial, and I want a font to be bold, thick, solid, and it should be italic also, with the font size of 20. So how I made a particular font for my graphic class is, g.setFont. So whatever the information I want to display, I will display with the help of this particular setFont of f. But how we can retrieve that part? So we created a font, but a particular font information we can read whenever we have a text is displayed. From that particular text, how we can retrieve the what is the ascent size, what is the baseline, what is the descent. So this information how we can retrieve is by using the font metric class. So see here, for my font metric class object, I'm getting that information is g.get font metrics of f. So what is f? F is the font class object. So this particular get font metrics will retrieve the information from the font object. And so based upon that particular created object, I am getting the ascent. I already said what is ascent is from baseline, the upgrowth is called as the ascent. So get ascent, get height, and also what is the height? Height is nothing but ascent plus descent plus leading. So that information we are retrieving. And so see here, how I am framing and how we are getting a baseline is, the baseline is how we can retrieve is ascent plus, so for example, next line baseline, how we can progress is leading plus ascent. If you add for this particular leading, if we add ascent, we will go to the next line baseline. So this is how we created the variables. So ascent is from the baseline upgrowth. What is height is leading plus descent plus ascent. And what is leading is the logical space between the two lines. And what is how we can get the next baseline is, next baseline is equal to leading plus ascent. So this is how we can. So here I am displaying the strings on my applet by using g.drawString method. And on the baseline, the information will be displayed. For the next line, how I am progressing is baseline is equal to current baseline plus height. So what is meant by height? Height is nothing but ascent plus descent plus leading. That's why it is automatically displayed in the next line. So this is how we can do.